And welcome back to Pick of the Week, where we look at the state of the Winter Awards races. I'm Michael Schneider.
I'm Danielle Turchiano. So we're coming off the 77th annual Golden Globe nominations. They were announced on Monday. And right now we're ready to dive into the lead limited series TV movie actor and actress races. Some interesting choices in that
one. We have thoughts, don't we?
We do, yes.
You know, there are a lot of things that were snubbed, most importantly, When They See Us, that got a goose egg, which was a little bit of a shock. Darrell Jerome, who won the Emmy in the lead actor category, obviously snubbed, but so was everyone else with that show.
True. And I mean, in this category specifically also, it feels a little like Aaron Paul from El Camino, the Breaking Bad movie, was snubbed. I mean, it was one of those entries where it was the really only television movie that was in the conversation.
Yeah.
And it was also something that had been beloved by the HFPA in the past.
Yeah.
And that also didn't crack in.
I mean, I would have loved Ian McShane as well from Deadwood the movie, which again, you know, that was earlier in the year, so I think a lot of people forgot about it by this point. But on the flip side, you had a couple of surprises, most notably Catch-22 and Christopher Abbott. Mm. That was a shock.
It feels like it's one of those things where the star power probably helped. George Clooney, Grant Heslov as producers and as actors in the project. Maybe that was enough.
They want Clooney to show up at the Golden Globes, and now he has a reason to. Another star who was nominated last year for his Showtime show, this year nominated for The Spy, Sacha Baron Cohen. He's a Golden Globes favorite. The HFPA love Sacha.
And it was interesting because it's a dramatic turn, which is so different from what he's done before. And as immersive as he is with his roles, I feel like so is Russell Crowe, who got nominated for The Loudest Voice, playing Roger Ailes. Just, we've talked about this, he just was completely unrecognizable. And that seemed to be a big part, in addition to his star factor, to push him into the race.
Yeah, and then you had Jared Harris from Chernobyl. Mm-hmm. Jared Harris is sort of Hollywood acting royalty to some degree at 4 nominations. So Jared's out there. And then Sam Rockwell.
Yeah, from Frosty Verdon. I mean, and he also, you know, these guys, a lot of them had to play real life figures and just become people that we all had an idea of who they were and what they looked like. And to be able to do that and capture the attention is quite a feat. And I feel like before we move into the actress race, we should do our pick of the week for the actor race.
Okay.
It's a tough race for me. I feel like I would give it to Jared Harris from Chernobyl. He was Emmy nominated and he lost that one to Darrell Jerome. But, you know, he played this real life scientist who had to investigate the 1986 disaster. And it was a combination of a lot of technical terms and very like hard hitting facts. But he added so much emotion and depth and sympathy that I just feel like it's his time. He deserves some award.
I will raise you that with Russell Crowe, because for the reasons that you mentioned, I mean, he really did transform into Roger Ailes, really emulating that person. Mm-hmm. We know so much about Roger Ailes, but, you know, to personify that and really sort of look the part, act the part was, you know, pretty amazing. And Russell Crowe, we know, is up to the task. So I wouldn't be mad at either of them.
Yeah.
So why don't we switch over to the actress category now in limited series. We were talking about Fosse Verdon, we're talking about Sam Rockwell. So his partner in crime, Michelle Williams, also nominated for lead actress in a limited series.
Michelle was obviously nominated and won the Emmy this year for the role of Gwen Verdon. And we've seen so much of what she can do. And it's undeniable that she was amazing in the role. But I want to also talk about the two women from Unbelievable. In some ways, they might split a vote. Caitlin Dever plays the real-life Marie, who is a sexual assault survivor and who really leads the show in the sense that we start in her point of view. But then Merritt Weaver comes in as a detective who's investigating the case. And it really starts to shift points of view, which I find so fascinating for the show, but also for this race.
Well, I think that is the show that'll get probably the biggest boost from the nominations on Monday and the power of those performances. Another nominee that, I think, you can't discount ever is Helen Mirren.
I was going to say power of performance, Helen Mirren.
Yeah. And, Helen Mirren, she ticks all the boxes for the HFPA. A show that didn't get a lot of attention in the U.S.
True.
But nonetheless, she's Helen Mirren. You know, she could have been nominated for Reading the Phone Book and we'd be like, yeah, give it to Helen Mirren.
And then the final nominee, Joey King, nominated at the Emmys for The Act. And again, here, it's a show that feels like it came out a long time ago. And yet, it's still resonating, partially because of the performances and partially just because of that true life crazy story of, you know, this woman who had Munchausen syndrome by proxy and the daughter that was imprisoned that then turned the tables on her.
Yeah. And honestly, of most of the performances that we've seen this year, I still think about Joey King with her shaved head playing Gypsy Rose, that character. Mm-hmm. And you know, she did a tremendous job. It's such a tremendous story that honestly, she's my pick.
I was going to ask. She's your pick of the week.
You know, I thought Joey was excellent. I mean, these are all excellent performances. Mm-hmm.
It's interesting. I love Joey's performance. I will say my pick of the week this time is for Caitlin Dever from Unbelievable. It was such a harrowing story to watch her as Marie, literally in her point of view during the attack, and then the aftermath of just how her whole worldview changed, including how the trauma affected what she thought of her own memories and how she couldn't trust herself. And that was just, I think, a perspective we just don't see that often, and I can't imagine what it took for her to get to that place as an actor. So I would love to see her get some recognition for that.
Excellent. Well, we'll find out on January 5. For mm-hmm. more Globes news and also up-to-the-minute TV news in general, check out Variety.com. I'm Mike Schneider.
I'm Danielle Turchiano.
We'll see you next time.